Garcia Jimenez.
Selena Garcia Riveros.
For 6 months.
Fine.
Pay a fine of $75 plus mandatory court assessment of $26.50. Is that all?
Jose Ochoa.
Do you have any questions for him?
The lady in the black jacket.
Supervision needs are under the jurisdiction of the court for that 6 month period. And at the end of that, you've done everything you're supposed to.
Have you done on the black hoodie?
Out a conviction.
Michael Johnson.
Any other questions?
All right, right there.
Thanks, board members.
James Smith.
Clarence Wright.
Go ahead.
The gentleman who's written on.
Hello there, sir.
Jennifer Olson. Warren Strickland.
Guilty.
The lady in the black jacket. Alexander Galeana Delgado. Gentleman in the blue jacket. Maria Tapia.
Yes, for supervision. Means that this will not be.
Black jacket. Kelsey Steele. Raul Solis Tenorio. Yara Douglas. Everybody checked in, going down to Wayne's Gravel.
So, I can't talk loud, you guys. Well, I had to go to court today because a truck driver tried to drive me off the road on the 2nd of January. So that's what I'm coming to court for.
Alexia Hunter. Hello there. Just have a look at your offer to defer prosecution. Please accept. Let's see on this slide. Trevor, looks like this Hunter completed the community service for the deferred prosecution. Okay, so this case is being dismissed. You're all done. Good job. Craig Hill.
Hello
there.
Good morning.
He's like a cool judge, man. Yeah, old girl, give me the save.
$500 plus the mandatory assessments. That includes $325 as the major traffic offense assessment. understand that the maximum possible penalty for driving with a revoked license is up to a year in jail, fine up to $2,500. There is also a mandatory minimum sentence if you're convicted of the offense, at least 10 days in the county jail or 240 community service hours. You understand all that? Notwithstanding those other potential penalties, was I correct in that it's 12 months of conditional discharge, $500 fine plus mandatory assessments, and 240 community service hours? Has anyone threatened you to get you to plead guilty, forced you to do so, or made you any promises other than the terms of the agreement? This is what you should. If you don't have to plead guilty, you have the right to plead not guilty to have a trial in this case. That could either be a jury trial or one people from the community would be selected to hear the evidence to determine whether or not the city of Gurnee proved you guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. Or the alternative defense trial where a judge would hear the evidence, the same burden of proof, the judge would make that determination. But by taking the law, there will be neither kind of trial. Is that your signature on the bottom of the waiver?
Yeah.
Where you provide the opportunity to review this before signing. This does, Mr. Hill, lays out some of the rights you're giving up since there won't be a trial. For example, the right to hear and confront the witnesses and evidence against you, the right to present evidence and witnesses of your own if you wish. But because there's no trial, you're giving up this trial. I understand that. Counsel, you stipulated that your client was driving on a public highway while the presence was informed that it was a prior DUI or such.
Yes,
great. And I will accept this. I will place you on conditional discharge for the year with the 240 community service hours, fine of $500 plus the assessments. Now, Mr. Hill, because you agreed with all of this, there's really nothing to appeal. If you wanted to appeal, the first step would be filing within 30 days of today's date a written motion to withdraw or take back your plea of guilty. In that motion, you would have to set forth all the reasons your motion would be granted. If you fail to include a reason, it would be considered. If your motion is granted, basically we put aside this plea, start all over, set the case for trial. If your motion is denied, you would then have 30 days from that point to file a written appeal. It's really important, sir, that you follow all of these rules, because if you don't, if you fail to comply with the terms of your conditional discharge, Gurnee can come back and ask to revoke it. You could be resentenced up to that year of jail, up to the maximum allowable by law. You understand that, please, sir? I know it's a lot of information. Do you have any questions for me?
Okay.
Thank you. You can step over and see the clerk. Appreciate it. Thank you. Take care.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
Kimberly Petaloza? Hello there, ma'am. Good. Have you ever issued a ticket charging you with speeding? How do you want to proceed on that ticket? Bill, how old are you? Do you have any other tickets last 2 years? Martinez. Hello there, sir.
So, sir, the Village of Gurnee filed a petition to revoke. Basically, they're asking to revoke. Your court supervision, they allege that you failed to complete your intake interview with the compliance
committee. Have you done that now? My lawyer,
okay.
have a second? So Mr. Rivera Martinez is here for PTR Raymond, failure to check on compliance. Mr. Strathman apologized that it was his fault that he didn't take it to. He has since.
You registered Raymond, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to prove and withdraw PTR. Yes. Yeah, he thought about that.
Okay, so, sir, basically, what's happening is they're withdrawing their petition. So you are now back on your petition. You have, just follow all the prior orders you have. Any other payment and traffic school? Okay, all right. So you are just back on supervision. Do you have any questions for me? All right, thanks. Take care. Daniel Vada. Hello, sir.
Witnesses any car crashes? Anybody here involved in a car crash did not get a ticket?
Morning, how are you?
Good. Do you have Selena Garcia Maveros?
Hello, ma'am.
I have to issue tickets charging with driving without a license and driving without insurance. Let's start with the license. Do you have a license?
Okay.
Just to have a look at that ticket. Juan Morales.
Juan Morales.
Good morning.
How are you?
Well.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, it appears that the village attorney is asking to dismiss both of your tickets. You're all done. Thank you.
This is
Mr. Alvarado, sorry. On Craig, I went off that for $500, but there was a different amount here. I'm just trying to make sure.
Yes, this is the correct amount because it's a credit for above and service hours, and we wanted to go through the net of 500. So this is actually more correct.
Okay, well, I advised him on the 500, you know, on board. Well, he's still here.
No.
So the intention was that the balance after the credit was supposed to be 500.
Yes, correct.
All right. Mr. Hill, can you step back over for a second?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Alvarado, let me ask you to read that one, that just that page then, so it's clear. All right, so I misunderstood when I went through this all with you. So the intention was that the grand total of the financial component, that took everything, because you didn't have the seed money in there, right? Or is this supposed to be that just what Ernie is getting? The conditional discharge fee wasn't included on the order, so I added it. So the idea that his grand total is to be 500, or is it 500?
Oh, 500, that's a
okay.
This is the third time around.
Right.
The driver is going to need to break that one.
Okay. In that case, can I ask you gentlemen to just fix the math on that? We'll call Mr. Hill back up.
Yes.
Okay. We'll fight right back.
Mr. Hill, you can just have a seat for now.
Sorry, we'll fix that. Jose Ochoa? Hello there, sir. Mr. Ochoa, it looks like you had a balance of 8650 and being paid off. You're going to pay it off right now? Okay. Go make the payment, then bring back in your receipt. Okay. Mark Whittle Brinson? Hello there, sir. Good, thanks. Is Brinson an issue to get charged on this fee? The application is that you're going at 31 miles an hour over the posted limit. That would make that a Class B misdemeanor, which means the maximum possible penalty is up to 6 months in jail, a fine of up to $1,500. Do you understand that? And how would you like to proceed on this ticket today? Would you like to ask for some time to consult a lawyer? Would you like to be back there and set up for trial? On the 10 month plea of guilty, what would you like to do today? Guilty? Okay. Do you have any other traffic tickets in the last 2 years? So as I mentioned, this is a class B misdemeanor. One of the things... One of the things I can do, sir, is pass the case that allow you to speak to the prosecutor. That's Mr. Alvarado, the gentleman right there. He may, stress may, because he's not required to, be willing to reduce it to a petty speeding ticket. That would save you some money just on the court assessments. Okay. So we're going to pass the case. I'll talk to you when he gets a second. Couple things I tell everybody, because you're negotiating the case on your own behalf. One is, as I mentioned, he's not required to reduce it for your benefit. No matter, secondly, no matter what he offers you, you do not have to accept his offer. You still can step back up and have all of those same options available in these cases. So you have to talk to a lawyer, plead not guilty, plead guilty in front. Okay, any questions? All right, have a seat. It's Michael Johnson. Hello there, sir. Good, thank you. Mr. Johnson, you issued a ticket for charging with speeding. The allegation is that you're going 25 miles an hour on the course of the limit. How would you like to proceed on this ticket? Do you have any other traffic tickets in the last 2 years? All right, so I'm placed on supervision, sir. That means that this will not be a conviction or anything, based on 25 miles an hour over the course of the limit, that would be $525. There are mandatory assessments that are set by the legislature. Those are $226.50. So your grand total will be $351.50. How much time do you need to pay that off? Great. Okay. So I'm placed on supervision for 3 months. In just a moment, you're going to step to your right and you're going to talk to the court clerk. She's going to give you a copy of this court order I'm filling out right now. She'll also give you information on ways that Microsoft office looks at something. Cool. As long as you pay it in full by the 3 month rate, which will be less than other words, you don't have to come back to court, that will not be a conviction. Do you have any questions for me, Mr. Johnson? All right, thank you, sir. I'm going to step to the court. Take care. James Smith? Hello there, sir.
Hello.
All right, so Mr. Smith, you were issued an ordinance violation ticket alleging that you committed the offense of disorderly conduct. The allegation is that he brandished a knife in such a way as to alarm and disturb the peace.
Can I explain my reasons?
Well, let me give you your choices first, and then you tell me what you want to do next. So the first option is you can ask for some time to talk to a lawyer if you want to seek legal advice in your case. I'm not allowed to give anybody legal advice. That's option number one. Option number two is you can plead not guilty, and you can ask for a trial on this charge, where you have to be proven guilty by a preponderance of the evidence. A third option is you can plead guilty, and I would sentence you right now. If you plead guilty or are found guilty, I'd give you your chance to kind of explain your side of the story. What would you like to do?
Plead guilty.
Okay. So go ahead, sir. Tell me what's going on.
I was driving, coming from Indianapolis on the 2nd of January, and the semi truck, he was driving a little slow, so I signaled to go to the left. I sped up in front of him, and I signaled to go to the right. He took it upon himself to directly be behind me and try to run me off the road with my family in there, and I gave him a warning, and I smacked my knife to the outside of my truck. I didn't wave or nothing like that, but that's what happened.
Okay. Well, you see outside of your truck?
Yeah, the door.
Okay. Are you a CDL holder?
No, he was, the guy.
So he was, and you were just in a family program?
Yes.
Okay.
All right. I mean, I'm the only man in my house, and I was doing anything to protect my family.
No, I appreciate that. So have you ever been arrested for a criminal offense or an ordinance violation before?
Not like that.
So I will accept your plea of guilty. I will sentence you to pay a fine of $100, plus there are mandatory court assessments that apply. Those are another $100, and I'm going to order that. While you're on supervision, you have no contact with Kevin Grant. I'm not going to order you to do any public service, anything like that.
Okay. I have half. I got $100 on me now. So.
Okay. I'll give you up to 6 months to pay.
Okay.
Supervision for 6 months.
Okay.
So, sir, supervision means this is not a conviction, and that's important for you because, you know, if you're applying for jobs or any other thing where they ask you to criminal record, if they say, have you ever been convicted of anything? You have not.
It's a Brunson.
Conviction as long as you get everything paid off.
Awesome.
Now, sir, I just want to caution you, obviously, I think you understand from this that in the future, if there's any incidents,
yes,
to handle, if somebody's driving in a dangerous way, it's to call the police. Not,
yeah, I understand now.
Okay. Yes. Do you have any questions for you, Mr. Smith?
No, sir.
All right, you can step over and see the clerk.
Okay.
Mr. Hill? Okay. All right. So, whatever. So what I am being told is the idea of the intention of this was that this would be full of fines in excess of $530. Is that your understanding?
Yes.
Are you agreeing to pay that?
Yes,
sir. Hello. Yes, Smith. He told me, this is you, the clerk, right?
Oh, you got
the clerk. Okay. Do you have any questions about the modification?
No, sir.
All right,
thank you. Thank you very
much. All right, let's see if we got the clerk.
I got a couple of short questions. The truck driver tried to bring us off the road, and I can't take it from the police. I would find me a lawyer, that's all.
Okay.
Excuse me.
You're a Schwab? Schwab, are you last in line, please,
sir?
All right.
All right, this case will close right now. Good job.
It's, I can't read part one.
It's.
Millie, ready? The next line, blame the lack of the judge.
Hi. 9 o'clock, Roberto Santos. And 1:30, Miguel Sanchez.
I could pay it off. You said I have enough time? Okay. Thank you. Lawyer, sue dude.
You should have mentioned that he said you had a gun and the police pulled us over and got out of your family. That's what you should have told the judge.
I know, man.
No, it's, oh, it's in the car?
That's a different matter, no contact, but.
I have your number, I can just call you.
Yeah, I was gonna see you no matter what. No matter what I told him. He said I had a gun, but I'm gonna talk to him.
Yeah, or I can talk on the phone now.
He's a lawyer.
Okay, go for my car.